Hey guys, so a lot's happened to me over the last couple of weeks, but why don't you walk with me right now and I'll catch you up. So, to start off with, a couple of weeks ago I moved out of my Airbnb into what's going to be my home for hopefully the next 15 or so months. So that's this little place right here. So this is a neat little 5-bedroom duplex. I rent one of the rooms. And another 4 Christian guys are housemates of mine in there. So also, how good is this weather right now? Just last week we had a run of days where it was literally struggling to get above 0 degrees Celsius. I was freezing and it was miserable. But right now the sun's out and we're in the middle of a run of days that are above 20 degrees Celsius. I don't know what's going on with this place. It's like it's bipolar, the weather, but it's awesome. The trees are starting to bloom, and yeah, it's just great. So you're probably wondering why I'm walking and I'm not driving. So this is a bit of a challenge that I wasn't really ready for when I came over here. But basically my international student advisor strongly recommended, based purely on my visa class, that I do not get a car while I'm here. The reason behind that is, on my visa class, it is really, really difficult to get and then maintain a US driver's license. Apparently the bureaucracy and the paperwork is absolutely ridiculous, and then you have to renew it every 6 months and go through the whole process again. So given that I'm only here for 15 months, the advice I was given was don't do it, but that means that I am completely reliant on other people to drive me around. That wouldn't be such an issue, except that over here where I am in Kansas City, there is no public transport. There are also no footpaths, so I have to walk on roads. I have to constantly watch where I'm going. It's really difficult if you don't own a car. So again, completely reliant on my friends, my housemates, my classmates to drive me everywhere. So that's drive me to and from class each day, drive me to and from church on the weekends, drive me to go get groceries. They've been awesome about it. They've been absolutely awesome, completely willing to do it, help me out every time that I need help. Together we've gone into Kansas City, we've gone exploring, we've seen the main shopping town center. We've seen a number of different museums, art galleries. Eaten a whole bunch of different Kansas City barbecue, which is apparently world famous and tastes delicious. They've invited me to parties. We've gone out, done a whole bunch of different stuff, and they've just been above and beyond what I could have hoped for. Really making this doable for me. So really, really grateful for those guys. A number of you have also asked me if I've met any Australians while I'm here. There's one teacher on staff. She's been here for about 6 or 7 years, from I think Melbourne, Australia. She heard my accent on the first day, came out, had a chat, so we've bonded over that immediately. Otherwise, students, there's a couple of Asian Aussies, but they more, I suppose, have an Asian accent rather than Australian, so I stick out like a sore thumb. But people love my accent, they love my Australianisms, and they've taken to calling me Australia, which, let's be honest, is the greatest nickname I could have ever hoped for. So you might be wondering where I'm walking at the moment. So when I chose where I was going to live, I deliberately looked for a place that was just down the road from the International House of Prayer. This one room is a big part of the reason why I came over to IHOP here. It's weird to explain. It's this one room where 24/7 there are people in there praising and worshipping God. It doesn't make sense, but the idea is that in Matthew 6 we have the Lord's Prayer, and in the Lord's Prayer it says, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven." And that's the kicker: on earth as it is in heaven. In Revelation 4 we get a picture of what that means. We have a picture of a throne in heaven. It's surrounded by angels and different creatures, and their whole being is just worshipping that throne, saying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." That's all they do 24/7. And so this room seeks to try and capture that and replicate that in some small part. So even now, there are people inside that room just pouring their hearts out, pouring their love out at Jesus' feet. It's weird, and to be honest, it's intimidating. The first time I went into there, I didn't know what to think. But it's a great place to learn. The majority of their music teams are made up of students like me, studying at IHOPU. It's the heart of IHOPU. It's everything that they do. So you can probably tell, just walk through the car park, I'm here now. I'll give you a quick look at what it is, and then I'll try and sneak you guys inside and give you a quick look at what's going on inside this place. I'll catch you next time. The Spirit of